The University of Huddersfield, inspiring tomorrow's professionals.
So we're at the newly formed International Institute for Accelerator Applications, and we're going to go inside and see some of the exciting developments that are happening at the University of Huddersfield.
The Institute for, or the International Institute for Accelerator Applications, is based on the idea that accelerators are more than just toys for physicists. They play an important role in society, in everything from healthcare and defence through to pharmaceuticals and energy. And so what we're looking at is, instead of just simply designing accelerators for the sake of accelerators, we're designing accelerators that will have real use in the real world.
The Institute is covering all aspects of accelerator physics, including the very large ones at places like CERN and medium-sized ones at places like Daresbury. But as well as computer exercises and paper exercises and designs, it's got to be rooted in a real accelerator hardware in Huddersfield on the ground.
And it's an international institute because what we've done is brought together some key players in European accelerator technology and science.
So here we've got our first accelerator. It's a small one, sort of 20 kilovolts proton source, donated to us by Siemens.
We have a link with Siemens because Siemens are involved in accelerator applications in many areas, and they're developing new technologies and accelerators. So they have some really good ideas. What we have is the expertise in using accelerators and developing accelerators for applications. We're getting together with Siemens to look at ways of miniaturizing accelerators. If you want to build an accelerator, let's say, for example, for proton therapy for a hospital, you can't have something the size of the Large Hadron Collider. You need something that's small and compact and will fit in a basement and will run easily. So one of our goals is to work with Siemens to look at the miniaturization of accelerator technology for these sort of applications.
Proton radiotherapy is a way of treating cancer, a way of treating tumors, which is, depending on who you talk to, either a bit better or much, much better than conventional radiotherapy with X-rays. One of the things you can do with protons that you can't with X-rays is target the beam precisely onto the tumor, steering it both sideways and in depth. What this modulation system will do will enable us to send, or the surgeon to send, big bunches or small bunches to the appropriate part, so they can paint the tumor, the bit they want to destroy, not just in on-off black and white, but in different shades of grey and different currents. Okay, so let's start here. This is a little bottle of hydrogen gas. And when it's operational, a trickle of gas comes out of the bottle and down into the iron source through the gate here. So you've got a trickle of hydrogen molecules going into the vacuum chamber. They're then bombarded by a stream of electrons which come from up here and come down, and the electrons knock the atomic molecular electrons off the hydrogen, turning the hydrogen gas into hydrogen ions, which is just H plus, which is protons. So we've got protons in here. They're trapped by the magnetic fields and the permanent magnet and by the electric fields which we apply, until a field changes, a gate opens, and the protons come out. They're accelerated through 20 kilovolts or so, and they're selected and focused down the beam line. And down here we've got lenses, we've got a buncher which turns a stream of protons into bunches of protons and gaps. Then we've got, these are vacuum gauges, then we've got Faraday cups which can measure what arrives, measure its position, its spread. Further down we've got more diagnostic equipment to measure different things, so we can do different things along the beam line and see what the effect is. As it is now, that's fairly simple. What we're going to do is move all this lot out of the way and put a second stage in with more diagnostics, with more beam manipulation, magnetic and electric fields, static and RF, so that we can see what the protons do when we try and manipulate them. So over there we'll be getting our second machine, which will be a 30 milliamp high current iron source, courtesy of the University of Salford, where it's now surplus to their requirements. We're happy to take that over. That will give us lots of opportunities for other studies of things that happen at high currents, which you can't do with this machine. And then the next two rooms will be getting the medium energy iron source from Daresbury. That's a much, much higher energy machine, and that will be a general purpose facility for users from across the UK.
Well, STFC run a facility called MEIS, not M-I-C-E, but M-E-I-S, the medium energy iron source. And MEIS is used by a wealth of scientists, from material scientists through chemists, physicists, to look at ion beam effects on the surface of clean materials. It's used widely across the UK, and it also links in with some international programmes as well. It's been run by STFC for a number of years, but they're now thinking that they can't keep on running it, because as we know, the research councils are suffering from cutbacks, as everybody is. But we have got the ideal place to locate MEIS. We've got the ideal expertise to run MEIS. And so STFC are looking at transferring the entire facility over to Huddersfield. We will run it not just for our research, although it will be useful for accelerator development, but to actually run it as a facility so we get visitors from across the UK and probably across from Europe as well, doing their research here, looking at ion beam effects on the surface of materials.
What's interesting about it is you can scatter these ions off surfaces, and depending on the nature of the surface, on the atoms that make it up, on the crystal arrangement, on the impurities, on the way the planes link to each other, the ions will come off at particular angles with particular energies. And the point about the iron source is not just that you're bombarding a surface with ions, but that you're measuring what comes off the recoil ions in position and energy very precisely. And from that, you learn a lot about the nature of the surface you're looking at. Right, so this is going to be where the MEIS, the medium energy iron source, is going to be. And we're hoping to install it, probably starting around Christmas sometime. There's a lot of work that has to be done on the place first. We need to get the existing stuff that's being stored here cleared out. We need to get the place thoroughly cleaned up and lay on power supplies, vacuum, air pressure and so forth. But once we've got that all done, the source itself is going to be here, pretty much. This is a 200 kilovolt source enclosed in a platform. The protons will come out, they'll come down a beeline in this direction. They'll get bent and selected by a large magnet about here. Then they'll come through this very conveniently placed archway. The beamline will go on, and here we will have the detectors, the measuring devices, the chamber for preparation of specimens. We'll have a control room in there and space here for spares, experiments in preparation and that sort of thing. So it's going to be, you may not look like it very promising now, but it is going to be a really nice facility.
So the medium energy iron scattering source, or MEIS, is going to be built here in Huddersfield, and it's going to be a major facility for UK science in general, so it's a very exciting time for Huddersfield. So we'll be trying to follow it as it's being built, so watch this space. This space.